We've been married for 11 years. And we've had some real good times. Dougie can be real gentle. And he's funny. We've had a few good laughs.
All the same, it still doesn't give him any rights to...
You just keep your opinions to yourself. You don't know nothing. And I'm warning you, if you want to get out of this alive, don't do nothing to rile Doug.
Susan, I could hear you all along the corridor. What on earth's the matter?
Get out of here! Leave me alone!
What?
You lied to me. Liar! Liar!
I don't know what's happened.
My aunt sent me a photo of me mum.
Oh.
I never lied to you. No, but you let me think it was you.
Because I thought that's what you needed. I thought finding out the truth straight away would hurt you too much.
I trusted you.
Well, you still can. Everything I said, I meant. Phil and I, we want to give you a home and family.
Because you feel sorry for me, like everybody else has all my life. Do you think that's what I want?
No, Susie, because we care.
I just want my mum.
What Phil and I can give you is real, not make-believe.
You led me on. That isn't real, is it?
Oh, I didn't mean to hurt you. I thought... Oh, hell. Well, I thought you'd find out gradually that I wasn't your mother. But by then it wouldn't matter because you'd know I cared for you so much. It's the future that matters anyhow.
You must have all had real good fun laughing at me behind my back.
You know that isn't true. Everyone wants you to be happy. You've still got every chance.
Oh, no. Leave me alone. You've got me so confused. I just can't think straight.
Would you type this for me, please, Wendy, tomorrow, would you?
Yes, of course, Mrs. Davidson. Departmental, is it?
Yes. Actually, I wanted to talk to you about it. I've had another directive from Mr. Douglas about the article in the Dispatch.
Oh, dear.
He wants all correspondence from the prisoners checked before it leaves here.
That's impossible. Janet's gone. Meg's away on leave. We don't have the staff to cope with that.
Yes, I realised that, and I was about to ask Wendy if she would mind doing it.
Oh, I'd really rather not, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, I know it's a rather unpleasant job, but it's one that has to be done, and as Mrs. Powell says, we just don't have the staff. So would you mind helping us out?
All right, but I don't like it.
Thank you. I take it you haven't heard from your daughter yet?
No. There was a phone call earlier, though, from some woman.
Oh?
Yes, she told Wendy she wanted to talk to me about Jennifer.
And what did she have to say?
She was cut off before the call was transferred.
I see.
Oh, it's probably the mother of one of Jennifer's friends saying she's staying there. I have phoned everyone.
Well, she'll probably ring back.
She hasn't.
Well, perhaps something cropped up and she felt she'd rather talk to you at home. More private.
Hope so.
I think the best thing you can do is to go home and try to get some sleep. Don't come in tomorrow unless you really want to.
Thanks. If another call comes through for me, please make sure they know I'm home all evening.
Yes, of course, Mrs. Powell.
What are you wasting your time writing about restrictions and stuff for? I mean, we all know about it anyway, and I don't reckon the Dispatch is ever going to hear from us again.
You never know.
Well, you know what Davo said about the last one you wrote? The department were real mad.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Well, what are you bothering to write it for, then?
Because I'm going to have a damn good go at getting this posted.
Fat chance you've got.
Yeah, maybe next time we'll write an article about how they censor the mail in here.
Oh, you won't get that out either.
You're a right little ray of sunshine, aren't you? Anyway, I've got a plan.
What is it?
It might be okay, it might not. I'd like to keep it to myself for a moment.
Oh, you can tell me, can't you?
What's up, Susie?
My aunt sent me a letter.
I thought you'd be real pleased about getting some mail. I always am.
Shut up, Doreen. Come on, what is it, love?
Gee, she does kind of look like Joe, doesn't she?
Thank you, Doreen. Here, take care of Susie for a minute. I'm going to have a word to Joe.
Yeah, sure. I know you're feeling pretty bad, Suze, because it's a rotten thing to happen. But you still got your mates, you know. And it would have been a real surprise if your mum had turned up in here, wouldn't it?
Well, I've stuffed things up good and proper, haven't I?
I hate to say I told you so, but...
Oh, I only wanted to help.
Well, like I tried to tell you, it wasn't just any mother she was looking for. It had to be her bloody own.
I know. I just thought I had something I could give her.
Yeah, I know what you thought. Now the truth's out and the kid's hurt bad.
Exactly what I was trying to avoid.
So what are we going to do about it?
Look, I still think I've got lots to offer her. A real home and family, not just some make-believe thing she's chasing after.
Somehow I don't think she sees it like that.
Look, I really want to try. I think she's worth it.
Yeah, maybe the kid doesn't know when she's well off. How about we have a go together, see if we can't get her head out of the clouds?
Okay.
Come on.
Thank you.
No, I was about to ask you the same question.
Where's Robert?
I sent him over to Arlene's for the night.
You didn't let him go on his own, did you?
No, of course I didn't. Now, don't panic. Brian came over and picked him up.
Well, I'd rather he was here with us. We could at least keep an eye on him.
Look, he'll be perfectly all right with his cousins. I just thought that here he'd sense our worry and it wouldn't help matters at all, that's all.
You're probably right.
Anyway, she's sure to turn up, sir.
I hope so. I had a phone call today from a woman. Said she wanted to speak to me about Jennifer. She was cut off before I could speak to her.
Well, she's all right then, isn't she? She's probably staying with a friend, and now she's too scared to get in touch with us.
Oh, don't. She wouldn't do that. She's a good kid. What the hell are the police doing about it?
Darling, don't blame the police. The police are doing their best. They can't be expected to know everywhere a runaway kid would go, now, can they?
No, but I should know where my own daughter goes. Why didn't I take the time to find out more about her friends?
Oh, look, don't blame yourself, hun. Hell, you wouldn't even let her go over to Michelle's because you said you didn't know her well enough, or the parents for that matter.
I feel so damn useless. What about her address book? That could have a name in it that we've overlooked.
You know, it's pretty tough when you don't know where your parents are and that.
How did you find your mum? Advertise or something?
No, this Selvo bloke, Captain Barton, used to come visiting in here and I told him about my mum, you know, where I'd last seen her and stuff like that.
And he found her for you?
Mm. Maybe you should look him up. He could do something for you.
Oh, I don't know. They might get the wrong person again. That'd be awful. I'm not going through that again.
Yeah.
I don't think I'll ever be able to find her.
Oh, come on. Can't sit here feeling sorry for yourself all the time. We've all had our share of hard knocks.
I suppose you're right.
You just got to keep trying, you know, even when things get real rough.
Yeah, you're right. I'm going to plan another escape.
Crikey, that's not what I meant.
This time I'll really make it work for me. I'm going to go and ask some of the women if they've got a few ideas. Are you coming?
No. Not at the moment.
And what the hell are you up to? As if I didn't know.
Did you have to go and tell?
You see, Susie...
And it's just as well she did. Maybe we can talk some sense into you.
I know what I'm doing.
Oh, yeah? You don't even seem to recognise your mates when you've got them.
All I know is I've got no reason to stick around this dump anymore.
Oh, yes, you have. Now, listen to me, love. Last time you were up in front of the VJ, you copped it pretty sweet, but you fly the coop again and you won't know what's hit you when they get through with you.
I won't be coming back.
Judging by your track record, I wouldn't depend on that.
Well, this time's different.
Oh, hell, where have I heard that before? Look, you're going to be out of here in a couple of months. Now, why blow it?
Oh, that's forever.
No, it's not. Now, just sit pretty and you'll be out of here for good.
Oh, that's not true, V, and you know it. The screws will find something to keep me in here. Well, someone always has.
It's because you're so bloody stupid. Now, why don't you pull your finger out and just put up with things a little while longer?
No! None of you understand, do you? None of you!
We understand. You are being as silly as a cut snake. Now, you try any more of your dumb tricks, and we'll make sure you don't get away with them. Isn't that right, ladies?
Mm. You've got no right.
Oh, yes, we have. Someone has to make sure you don't stuff up the rest of your life.
Just leave me alone.
Oh, hell, if I hadn't been so stupid, none of this would have happened.
There's no name here we haven't already called.
Madison Tucker, darling. Your favourite, steak and mashed buns.
Couldn't eat.
Well, I can't say that I'm exactly hungry myself, but we should at least make the effort.
Go ahead, eat. Just leave me alone, will you? I've got to think.
Oh, I'm sorry, hon.
Jennifer's missing. God knows where she is. When her last meal wasn't, all you can think of is your damn stomach. You don't even care.
Don't say that, Cole.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
It's just all this waiting has happened. It's just... I'm so scared.
Oh, come on. Come on.
All right, ladies, come on. There's no prices for being first.
Crikey, you'd think she didn't have a friend in the world the way she's carrying on.
No. Silly little bugger.
Still feel sorry for her, but...
So do I. Well, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink.
Hmm.
Hey, listen, Doreen, go on ahead, will you? A minute, I want to have a talk to Steve.
What about?
Never you mind.
Look, sometimes I think I haven't got a friend in the world either.
Present for you, Mr. Fawkner, or rather for your journal, friend?
You heard Mrs. Davidson. The weekly stir stays strictly inside Wentworth.
Oh, I asked you to take the weekly stir out. This is a B-Smith special.
Sorry.
Maybe I've got the wrong Mr. Fawkner. The one I knew was for freedom of the press.
Yeah, I was. I am. But I'm not going to lay my job on the line.
Well, I'm not going to tell anybody if you don't.
The way things are at the moment, I could get search going out of here. And if they find that on me, it'd be goodbye Wentworth, hello doll queue.
Well, just slip it into the post. They won't know it's not your own litter.
Addressed to the dispatch? You've got to be kidding. If they find that, I'd be up on a trafficking charge.
Hey, hang on. You're the one that put me up to this writing, Mark. Now some bureaucrat's starting to get heavy. You want to cop out.
I told you I don't agree with the restrictions.
Oh, but you'd rather be an armchair stirrer, huh?
No, I wouldn't. I'll take it to reception and leave it with the outgoing mail, okay?
Checked all of the night spots. Look, I really don't think you'd find her in any of those places. Yes, yes, all right. Thank you. Nothing from the police.
I didn't think so. That'll let us know. Come on, love, you better get ready, eh? You'll be late for work.
Oh, I'm not coming.
You'll feel better there.
I don't want to. You go if you want to, but I'm going to stay here in case that woman rings.
Well, she got in touch with you at Wentworth yesterday, didn't she?
Well, if I'm not at work, they'll give her my home number. Besides, if I am there at work and I'm not near a phone, she could be cut off before I'm located.
That sounds a bit iffy to me, love. Now, come on, she rang the prison yesterday. She'll probably ring again today, eh?
You think so?
Besides, there's nothing worse than being at home in an empty house waiting for the phone to ring, eh?
No, I suppose you're right.
I know I'm right. But come on, get ready, eh? I'll drive you.
Bloody hell, Joe. Wish I was getting out with you tomorrow.
Yeah, me too.
We'll have fresh air and sunshine down the farm. Hey, Susie, how about you go for us?
You make me sound like a stray cat or something.
It's really pretty good out there. Hard yakka, but it's worth it.
I reckon it'd be real good living on a chook farm, all them fresh eggs for breakfast.
Certainly beats the muck we get around here.
Now, you don't keep the chooks in any of them battery things, do you? I saw one of those programs on telly, you know, it looked real cruel.
Nah, of course not. All our animals roam free.
Yeah, well, wish I had something like that to look forward to. You wouldn't catch me saying no.
Well, Susie, what about it?
I've already told you, I'm not coming. Well, how about I give you my address? You might change
your
mind.
Just leave me alone, will you? Mrs. Bailey, I'd like to work somewhere else, please.
What's the matter?
Nothing. I just don't want to work here anymore.
Why, Susie? Is there something wrong?
No. I'll go on cleaning duties. Anything.
I'm sorry, the rosters can't be changed at this late stage.
Please.
You should have put in a request earlier, before the paperwork was done.
What's that you're up to, Wendy?
I'm supposed to check the prisoner's mail before it goes out.
What?
Well, don't look at me like that. It's Mrs. Davidson's orders.
Hell. There are one or two new restrictions, but this is ridiculous.
I know. I can't say I enjoyed doing it. Most of these are private, between husband and wife, that sort of thing.
You think they'd be entitled to that, wouldn't you? Bloody bureaucrats. Mm.
That article you gave to Matt certainly made a few waves.
You could say that, yeah.
Wentworth Detention Centre. Yes, sir, it is possible, but you'd have to get the governor's permission. Mrs. Davidson.
How'd you go?
It was a bit dicey, but everything went okay. Mm-hmm. They're censoring all the outgoing mail.
Oh, it would surprise me. Lousy, bludges your stuff before you start round here.
Maybe not. This could be the one that got away.
For sure.
No, but we'll soon find out.
I really appreciate it.
Glad to help, this time. From now on, you're going to have to find yourself another postboy. Me and my yacht couldn't take that dog queue. Not even for freedom of the press.
Thanks, anyway.
Mr. Fawkner, I'd like to see the governor, please.
All right, I'll arrange for it.
I'd like to go now.
Oh, come on, we'll see if she's available.
Thanks.
I hope Dave can knock some sense into her.
Yeah. Hey, what were you and Spunk talking about? You're a real pally there for me.
They are censoring all our outgoing mail.
Oh, crikey, they can't do that.
Oh, they can. They have. We're not taking any chances.
Well, you're not going to get your story out now.
Don't you bet on it. I think this time he might come through for us.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Powell.
Morning. Have there been any phone calls for me?
No, sorry. Before you go, could you check this letter for me? I'm not sure whether it should go through or not.
Knew this would happen.
It's that part about the shower box not being fit to drown a cat in. I know it's meant to be a joke, but...
Well, of course it shouldn't go through. Well, what's all this? The comments about the officer, why haven't you crossed those out?
Oh, but they've all got comments like that.
And you've deleted them, I hope.
Well, no, I didn't think they mattered. I mean, nobody's going to take something like that seriously.
Wendy, this is why you're asked to do this. This is exactly the sort of thing you should be looking for. Oh, have to do all the damn things again.
Oh, what did you want to see me about, Susan?
I'd like to be moved to the garden, Mrs. Davidson.
Is something wrong?
No, I'd just like a change.
Well, I thought you liked being in the laundry. You've made quite a few good friends there, haven't you? What's the matter, Susan? I just don't understand. You have everything to look forward to and you won't be with us for much longer.
I've got ages to go yet.
Oh, I wouldn't call a few short weeks ages. You'll have every chance of being released from here long before your release date is due, you know.
You mean I don't have to wait 3 months?
Probably not. If we can show the department that you have suitable employment and a good place to stay, I'm sure they'd be very happy to review your case.
Huh.
One of the women has already spoken to me about the possibility of your coming to live with her and her family.
I'm not staying with Joanne Slater or anyone else like that.
Why not?
I've been dumped on people all my life. Well, that's why not.
All right. But you realise you will not be released early if you have nowhere to go. And if you cause any trouble between now and then...
Don't worry. You won't even know I'm here.
Well, I'll speak to Mrs. Morris when she returns about accommodation and a job for you. In the meantime, I see no reason why you shouldn't be transferred to garden duties if that is what you wish.
Oh, gee, thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
Come in.
Can I see you for a moment, Mrs. Davidson? It's very important.
Very well. Mr. Fawkner, would you arrange for Susan to work in the garden, please?
Right, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, what can I do for you?
Everybody's back now.
Okay.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes?
Are you on outside duty?
Just on my way.
Good. I'll leave Susie with you then. She's been reassigned to garden duties.
Oh?
It's been okay by Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, well, I guess it must be all right then. Come on, Susie.
I gather Officer Powell found a letter B. Smith was trying to smuggle out.
Yes, she was ropeable. I thought I checked them all thoroughly. I don't know how it got there. Can't recall any of the women being near my desk.
In fact, you were the only one that showed any interest in the letters.
Okay, guilty. Well, how was I to know Powell would be on the warpath? Sorry.
All right, well, I won't breathe a word, but I've got a feeling that associating with you journos is going to make things a bit hot for me around here.
To be out in the sunshine and fresh air, isn't it, Miss Bailey? Why do you think Susie went to see old Dover?
Well, Pam's been sitting here, so I guess she's asked for a change of duties.
Yeah, she really jacked up on us, didn't she?
Personally, I'd rather have her in here so we could keep an eye on her.
You really think she'd try to escape again?
Good chance of it.
Well, we've got to stop her.
How?
Yeah, you can't lag.
But if she goes before the VJ again for escaping, what'll happen?
Oh, come down her like a ton of bricks and throw everything they can at her.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, she was bloody lucky to get a concurrent sentence last time.
Yeah. Okay, ladies, exercise time.
And what do you think we've been doing all morning?
Yeah, B's been doing press-ups all morning.
I'll recommend you for the joke section of the Weekly Stir.
Hey, you know where Susie is?
Garden duty. Bad news. Officer Powell found your letter.
Oh, bloody lovely. If she's sifting through everything, nothing will get out.
Actually, they gave the job to Wendy.
What? She's not even a prison officer.
Oh, I know, but she didn't have any say in it either.
Oh,
thanks.
Hey, Susie's on garden duty, you know. And before you came along, she had this plan.
To escape?
Yeah, Lizzie said that she stashed a shovel away in the garden and she was going to dig her way out.
Dave, I see if she wants to do something.
Susie, don't, please. Look, I still want you to come and live with us. We'll be a real family.
I'm going to make it my own way. I'll not bludge off strangers.
I am not asking.
No, she's right. You can't live off charity all the time, you know. You've got to have your own respect.
Don't you think I know that?
Knock it off. It's about time someone spoke to you about the real reasons why you keep trying to escape, Susie. Just listen to me a minute. It was because you want to get out of here. That is pretty silly because you are being released soon anyway. But if it's because you want to hurt Joe, well, that is pretty bloody stupid. She may not be your mother, but she's been a damn good mate and all she wants is the best for you. So why are you doing it?
She's right, Susie. Even if you don't want to come with me, why throw away your future by trying to escape again?
Yeah. Okay. I reckon I'll give it a miss.
Colleen.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
There's no need to apologise. Is there anything I can do? You haven't had any news yet.
One night was bad enough. Tried to convince myself that she stayed out all night despite me. Even though it's not like her, but... two. I just don't know what's happening to the poor little devil. I feel sick with worry.
I wish I could do something to help.
Well, nobody can.
Well, I can suggest one thing, and that's that you go home. Perhaps try to get some rest. You certainly look as though you could do with it.
No, I'll be all right in a minute.
No, Colleen. If the women know what's wrong, they could use it against you. I think under the circumstances, it's the best thing to do.
Yes, yes, you're probably right. Anyhow, not much use around here the way I feel.
Oh, and get something to go on the bread, tomatoes or something like that.
Might be easier to tell me what you don't want.
Mel, I want you to do something for me. Ring up the girl's parents.
Me?
Well, just to let him know that she's all right, so they don't worry.
Yeah, Dougie found out.
Dougie won't. All you got to do is say she's all right, then hang up.
Yeah.
Look, she promised me if I do this, she won't try and clear off again. Anyway, might take the heat off us if the parents know she's all right.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks, Mel. Tell me, Tino.
Thank you, Mrs. Bailey. Well, Smith, what is it?
Our mail is being well and truly censored.
Yes, it was a departmental directive.
Well, a bloody unreasonable one. We are human, you know. We do have rights.
I realise that.
Well, obviously, the powers that be don't. For starters, our mail should be private. And I thought there was something in this country called freedom of the press.
Normally, I would agree. The press should be free.
Well, then my article, or anyone else's for that matter, should be allowed through.
I am sorry the department has seen fit to impose these restrictions, but you must remember you are prisoners, and as such, you have to obey the directives, no matter how unreasonable you may find them.
And knuckle under and not question whether it's fair or not, is that right?
Yes.
Well, can't you do something about that?
My hands are tied. I have to obey departmental directives too, you
know? Well, at least you and the screws can throw the towel in when you've had enough, but it's not your mail that's being censored.
You must accept the department...
Mrs. Davidson, that article of mine is going to get through to the dispatch, even if I have to sprout wings and fly it there myself.
Then security will have to be made even tighter. It's up to you.
Powell?
Yes, yes. Who is it?
Your daughter's okay.
Oh, thank God. Where is she? Who is this?
She's okay, but don't go looking for her.
What do you mean? Who is this?
Please, who's speaking?
Hello? Hello! Put me through. Inspector Lennox, please. Hurry.
No, that man's voice was certainly no one I know.
I wonder. The bank on the corner of Bruce and Lennox Street was held up at about the same time that your daughter disappeared.
You think they could be connected?
It's a possibility.
But Jennifer wouldn't have been anywhere near the bank.
But you may have seen them with guns or something like that. If so, they'd have taken her hostage. We found their getaway car in Gardner Lane.
Hello, Mum.
Hello, darling. Hey, heard anything from Jennifer?
No, nothing.
This is Senior Detective Lennox, my son Robert.
You're a real detective?
Yep. As I was saying, we found their getaway car in Gardner Lane.
Not the RX-7.
Yeah, that's right. How did you know?
Dad and me saw it when we were looking for Jenny.
Did you see any other cars in the vicinity?
Not just then, but before that, an E.H. Holden parked in the same spot. It was a real bomb.
Robert, think hard. Can you tell us any more about it?
Yeah, it was kind of, sort of pale yellow. And had a white roof. Yeah, it was really dirty, I remember, because I was able to write a few words on the dust.
Good boy. Well, that gives us something to go on. Excuse me, Mrs. Powell, I've got to pass this on.
Hey, Carol.
Let me go.
Oh, come on, love.
I've got things to do, Doug.
Yeah, well, so have I, eh? I'm having a chat with my favourite girlfriend. Yeah, that's better. Just you and me, love. It's always been the name of the game, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're good together. Things were okay when we worked on our own.
Geez, if we could just get away for a while, forget about everything.
Do you reckon we could?
Yeah, sure. We'll find somewhere quiet, eh? Have a sort of a second honeymoon.
and it would start off right this time.
Be great.
All we got to do is to get rid of our little problem in the back room.
What about Mel's plan?
Oh, sure. We'll do exactly what Mel says. We'll get real far out into the bush, and then we'll do what I say. And if Mel hassles us about getting rid of the kid, then I'll fix him too.
Would you kill Mel?
What's he to you? He'd better not be. We gotta stick together, love, and that way nobody gets in our way. Nobody.
We're going to make a double quantity and make a good big one.
Thanks.
This is absolutely heaven, and Scott's going to love it because it has marmalade.
You look like you've just been to a funeral.
Yeah. Flaming dead enough around here, and there isn't even anything decent on the telly.
That's right. I'd have liked to have written a letter to Wally, but I'm damned if I'm going to have it turn into light reading for Wendy at her coffee break.
Doesn't seem much point in it, does it, love?
Oh, no, you just stare at the walls. Anyone fancy a game of cards?
No. I thought you would have had something to do.
Yeah, like what?
Like writing another article?
I'm going to waste my brain power writing stuff that hasn't got a hope in hell of being published.
We would have published it.
Yeah, there's no point in having the stir if nobody's stirring.
You haven't given up trying to get that article out, have you?
Told Dave I hadn't. What the hell can I do?
Now, you listen here to me a minute, girl. Where's your fighting spirit?
Yeah. It's not like you to let the screws win hands down, love.
It's not just the screws, it's the whole damn department.
Bloody mongrels.
Besides, as long as they think I'm trying to get something out of here, they'll censor all the mail, and that affects everyone who wants to write a letter.
Yeah, well, we'd be willing to put up with that for a while if we knew you were trying.
What's the use?
Well, you won't know unless you try. Looks like the last one's getting Susie an early release.
That's right, love.
All right, anyone got any bright suggestions on how I get it to the outside?
You got another copy?
No, but I can remember what was in it.
Well, like I said before, I'm taking it with me when I get out of here tomorrow.
Look, the screws might be stupid, but they're not blind.
Yeah, they'll whip it off you, and then you won't be able to get out yourself.
No, I think I've got a pretty good plan. Screw-proof, you could say.
Mm. I'm a bit light on for better offers. Okay, I'll give it a burl.
All ready and reporting for duty, Mum.
Oh, Meg, it's good to have you back.
Well, I'd like to say it's good to be back, but I'm not sure yet.
Holidays are always like that. Did you enjoy yourself?
Yes, very much. Well, it's not every day I'm asked to be matron of honour in the Sunshine State.
Oh, the wedding was successful then?
Yes, yes, it was. Oh, it was only quite small, just a few relatives and friends. Janet's mother organised the whole thing. Oh, by the way, they asked to be remembered to you, and thank you very much for the present.
Good.
I'm afraid there's some rather unhappy news here. Colleen Powell's daughter is missing.
Jennifer?
Mm.
What, has she run away?
Well, Colleen doesn't seem to think that is the case. In fact, they just don't know what has happened.
Oh, that's terrible.
Yes. I've persuaded her to stay at home, but it must be an awful thing to go through.
Yes, well, it would be. Look, I don't mind doing her share if it'd make things easier.
Thank you. Well, perhaps you could start by arranging for this prisoner who will be arriving shortly. We've been given special instructions as to how she is to be treated.
You took long enough. Got to get out of here real quick.
Right. The cops are onto the car.
Don't tell me you're bloody followed.
No, I was on the radio. A full description. Bloody colour, make, everything.
How could they?
I don't know. But I tell you, I felt like a bloody freak sitting in the traffic, wondering if everyone else was listening to the broadcast.
Now, listen, are you sure you weren't followed?
Yeah, I'm sure. Look, we've got to dump that car and make a break for it.
Yeah, but we'll need some new wheels.
Well, I spoke to a mate of mine, and he can have a car by the morning if we front up with the dough.
Okay. But you've got to make sure you dump that Holden a long way from here.
Yeah. Oh, no worries about the plan, then?
Well, you can't be wrong all the time, can you? Well, get the dough. Don't keep your mate waiting.
Yeah, right.
Bought you some brekkie.
Are you taking me with you?
You shouldn't listen to things that don't concern you.
But it does. Oh, please, what are they going to do with me?
All I know is that things would go a lot easier if you would just mind your own business.
But you must know, please.
Mel got word to your mum.
Mel!
Keep your trap shut. If Doug finds out about this, he'll do the whole lot of us.
She'll be crazy with worry. What's she saying?
That's all I can tell you, Nap. Just shut up and eat your breakfast.
I'll bet your husband and your little boy will be glad to see you.
Yeah, I'll be glad to see them again. You know, Bea, I might even take this letter of yours to dispatch myself. To hell with the post.
No, don't do that. You don't want them finding out who got it out.
No, I'll front up when nobody's watching. Besides, I'd say he'd be sitting on the editor's desk in about 2 hours after his lunch break.
More likely he'll be sitting looking at us when we get back from ours. That's not my article got screwed up there, is it? What are you going to do with that?
I am going to substitute it for the wire in my uplift bra.
My God, what a...
I reckon it's going to do wonders for my figure. What do you think of that, lady?
Yeah, your article's going to bust out of here, Bea.
Crikey.
Very clever.
Oh, hello, Mrs. M. How was the wedding?
It was very nice, thank you, Lizzie. I'll tell you all about it another time. Joanne, you can go and get ready for your release. Mrs. Bailey's got your clothes here.
Okay, Mrs. Morris. Well, wish me luck, girl.
Good very luck. Best luck. Send her the chooks for us.
Okay, I will.
Righto, ladies, let's start the day with a walk in the garden, shall we?
Oh, yeah. Yippee-doo, we'll be.
Yeah, well, she'd have as good a chance as anyone to get that thing out of here.
She gets past the search, she'll be okay. Hey, what if it's Mr. Fawkner?
Then we're home and hosed.
Hey, looks as though she escaped the groping.
Yeah. Good on you, Joanne. Oh, I'll be really sorry to see her go. I mean, she might be a mute jump, but she knew how to fix the screws.
Yeah, for a poultry farmer, she's a pretty good egg.
Oh. Joe!
That was a yolk.
I just want to say, well, I know you did what you thought was right. Well, I reckon it was pretty nice of you.
I'm glad you think that.
I'm sorry I was rotten to you.
Oh, just forget it. You take care, okay?
You too. I wish you really was me, Mum.
Yeah.
Hey, looks like we've got a new guest arriving.
I know what poor bloody mug they've picked up this time.
You know, that's funny, they're not coming in.
Yeah.
Right, come on, ladies, inside.
Oh. Hang about, we only just got out here.
Never mind.
Oh, not enough time to even exercise a dog.
Inside. You're up to something.
Yeah. And I'd like to know what it is.
Cut our work period short or anything like that, would they?
No. I reckon the answer's in their paddy wagon.
You reckon they got somebody there that they don't want us to know about?
Right.
You mean like a child molester or something? Mm-hmm.
God, like that bloody Bella. Oof, if ever I got my hands on another bugger like her, I'd...
Whoa. Yeah, well, that's exactly why they keep her away from us.
Bella? Who's she?
Oh, a rotten bitch. She was in here for doing something very nasty to a kid.
Oh. Yeah, but we gave her hers.
Yeah, we'll have to hurry with this. Got to get the new one processed and into solitary straight away.
Erica Davidson?
Oh, Colleen Powell.
Oh, Colleen, how are you?
It looks as if Jenny's been abducted.
Oh, no. Do the police have any leads?
Yes. Robert was able to give them a description of their car. They must have hidden it near our place and Jenny would have...
Oh, well, I'm sure the police will get onto them now very quickly.
I hope so. Mrs. Davidson, look, would you mind if I didn't come in for a while? Just until I feel a little better.
Well, of course. Actually, I was going to insist on it. Meg is back and she's quite willing to take over your work. Please let me know if there's anything at all I can do.
Yes, I will. Thank you.
something for you, girls.
No, thanks a lot.
I stopped off at the rec room and I collected these because I thought you might like to have a bit of a gander.
Oh, hell yeah, give us a look.
Yeah, me too.
Well, what are you looking for?
If anyone's been put in here for kicking a kid around, I want to know about it.
Hey, we should do that to their own kid.
It's all the time. Love is a sick girl.
Any luck?
Not a flaming thing.
Nothing here, are we?
Well, maybe we were wrong.
Not necessarily. Maybe it just didn't make the papers.
Hey, maybe it was one of them terrorists, you know, like Janet Rodriguez. Anyway, I'm going, and I'm going to have a snoop around.
Yeah, you do that, Lizzie.
Well, I'm ready to piss off. I'll just go and pick up the new wheels from me, mate.
Yeah.
Well, aren't you going to start packing?
Sure.
So you'll be ready to leave as soon as I get back then?
Sure.
That was pretty good luck, the cops picking up a description of the car, wasn't it?
Why?
Because it made us get a faster one. And a faster one means we get into the country quicker. So we can dump the kid in Mel when no one's ever going to find them. And before you know it, baby, Perth or Darwin, and all our worries will be over.
Lizzie?
Oh, good day, Mrs. M.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I just thought I'd take a bit of a squiz in the solitary cells and see if I could pick up any dirty stuff.
Now, you know you're not supposed to be here. Now, get back to the laundry.
You got a new prisoner in there, have you?
It's none of your business. Now, off you go.
All right. I was only trying to check up. Bang her at you.
Didn't find anything out, eh?
Nah. I nearly got to the gates and Mrs. M came along and nabbed me and sent me packing.
Was that all? You're lucky it wasn't Po-Face. You would have been up on a charge.
God, I reckon I must be losing me touch. I bet Sherlock Holmes didn't have all this trouble.
No, don't worry. We'll find out sooner or later.
Well, I don't know so much about that. All security gates are locked. Mrs. M wasn't going to say anything. I reckon those screws are going to really stop us from finding out who's in there. Must be somebody real important.
I don't know about Darwin, love. Hey, what about Sydney? You can buy yourself some new gear. What's the matter with you?
Nothing.
They're bloody ears. Now, what is it?
What?
Well, what? Have you got some objection to my plan?
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you bloody say so when we were discussing it?
Discussing? You get your own way every time. What's the point in me discussing?
Well, why didn't you bloody say something before, eh? You know I'm always ready to listen to you.
All right. I don't want any more killing. We can just take Jenny out into the bush and no one will find her. If they do, we'll be miles away anyway.
You're crazy. We can't be bloody sure of that.
You said yourself that we were getting a faster car. And I think Mel should stay with us.
Why?
Because he's been in on the job from the start.
Yeah, so what?
We can't just dump him like he was nothing.
Listen, you're pretty bloody keen to have Mel tagging along, aren't
you? He's part of the team. He risked everything just like you, and at least he didn't kill any bloody guard.
You bloody bitch.
I just mean that we need someone who can keep their cool.
Who, like Mel,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, like Mel. He's got more sense than you'll ever have.
Lousy bitch!
Oh!
Things would have gone real well if it hadn't been for you.
No. Please don't
Don't hurt me.
Hurt you? I don't want to hurt you, baby. I just want to find out what you're good for.
No!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.